Hi guys, this video is for you who have just started working with SolidWorks. I would like to say at the very beginning of this video that you're going to have a lot of fun working with the software because it's a very user-friendly and yet capable of doing many, many complicated stuff for you in a very easy way. So let's just get to it. When you open SolidWorks, this is going to be the first screen you're gonna see. By the way, it's a 2011 version. So you may have installed or like worked with the newer version 2012, but I don't have it, so sorry for that. When you open the software, the program, this is the first menu, and then just to start, you have to either click on this or you see this initially anyway. You get three options over here apart from the advanced. Let go with that for now. Part assembly drawing. As it sounds, part is just to creating parts. Assembly is just to assemble the parts you have already generated within SolidWorks or in any other softwares and have imported in SolidWorks. And drawing is just an option for you to make 2D sketches, 2D drawings out of the parts or the assemblies you just made. Okay, I'm gonna make a part by either double clicking on that button or just clicking on it and click OK. There we go. This is the first screen interface you're gonna see after clicking on the part. As you can see, there are some unavailable options over here. Change the color, whatever. What was that? The important things are these tabs over here: feature, sketch, and one other for the initial way when you open the SolidWorks. I have added these tabs later, but this isn't an issue. Just let's focus on the very basic steps. Okay, if you're gonna start making any part, obviously you're gonna need sketches, 2D sketches, then turn it into 3D and make your part. Okay, so for that you need to go to the sketch tab over here. And here you see a couple of different shapes, and besides them you see an arrow, which even gives you more abilities, more sketches. So that's up to you what you wanna draw. Important, don't forget, before any sketches, ever, anytime, you need a plane. You need to define a plane in order to start a sketch, in order to draw a sketch. Okay, for that, SolidWorks gives you three initial planes, front, top, and right. So you just choose one and click on the sketch. It's a very basic method, but it's not necessary, but do it for now. So you can have a direct view of your sketch plane. I'm going to draw a rectangle, for example, like this. Okay, that's done. I still see a symbol of a rectangle just next to my cursor mouse, so it shows that if I click again, and by the way, click and let go with the button, drag the mouse and click again, it draw you another one. If you want to get rid of that symbol, just press the escape button on your keyboard. Okay, as you can see, the rectangle we just drew is blue, which means it's underdefined, as you can see also here. Underdefined means the shape is still editable and have no reference of being set or fixed. So for that, you either have to fix it by right clicking on that shape and click on make fixed, or just give some dimensions to it, which I'm going to do that. Here you see smart dimension, and below that you see an arrow which gives you many other options which are a little bit less advanced that smart dimension. Like for example, horizontal dimension only enables you to give dimensions to horizontal lines. You cannot define vertical lines by this option. But if you click on that, you can define any kind of line, angle, radius, or whatever. Okay, so I just clicked on it, and I see the symbol of that next to my cursor mouse, and I click on this vertical line over here, for example. Click again, give a random number for now. On this one as well, 200, there you go. I still see the symbol, so I press escape, that's it. Okay, I have defined two dimensions for my rectangle, for the length and for the width, but it's still in blue, so it tells you that the location, the place of this rectangle is not defined. So for example, you want to have your rectangle exactly at the center of the screen according to this initial origin you have. For that, you have a couple of options. Either you make a center line, which you don't see here, by the way. I have added this later, which I get to that. You just go to the line, to the arrow, click on it, center line, sorry. Click on it, center line, and draw one just like this. Press escape, right click on it, select midpoint, hold the control key on your keyboard down, and press the origin. Now, coincident. There you go. Now you have your rectangle in black, which shows you that it's not editable. If you want to edit the dimensions, you just have to double click on the dimension and change the dimension. Other than that, there is no way. Okay. Or, if you don't want to draw an additional line, just right click on the line, press midpoint, select midpoint, hold the control key down, origin, and give the sketch the vertical relation between these two points you just defined. Do the same for the vertical lines as well. Horizontal relation, as you can see, it's added here. There you go, it's in black with no extra center line. Okay, now let's just get to 3D. Now I have this in black, which is not a must, but it's suggested to be fully defined before you get to the feature tab. You have two options available for now. Extruded bus, which I'm going to start with. I click on it. There you go. Here, that's not important for now. Direction. You see the symbol, which can flip the side you're going to extrude your sketch. Okay. And this shows you the type of extrusion you're going to have on your sketch. Blind is just as it sounds, just blindly, you can just have it as much as you want by changing this number. This tab over here enables you to give directions to the extrusion you want to have on your sketch, but you need to have a reference to click on it, so it can understand which direction you're talking about. But for now, when you're gonna start, you have no reference. Therefore, just have we're going to cover the very basic one. Okay. By the way, I just need to add how I'm working with my mouse, how am I zooming back, zooming in, and how am I rotating the shape. Just a tip. Okay, it's really really easy. By the roller on your mouse, if you just roll it, it can zoom in or zoom out. And if you wanna rotate the shape, just press that roller on your mouse in and hold it and drag your mouse around. It's really really easy to use compared to other softwares I've worked with, which you have to hold like control key and alt together, then drag your mouse and whatever. Anyway, blind, mid plane, which puts your sketch in the middle of the extrusion. Up to vertex, which you need a vertex, we don't have at the moment. Up to surface, I'm gonna cover it. Offset from surface, up to body. I'm gonna get to all of them later. And over here, draft on off. It enables you to give angles to your 3D part, as you can see over here, or outward, like that. If I at any point click on this OK button over here, you can see the part in like block, but I'm just editing, so I'm not gonna do that. Just imagine I have OK'd it and it's ready. Okay, that's for that. Imagine you just want to have half of this angled and half of it really simple. So for that, you just need to click on the blind. Therefore, you see direction 2 as well. Click on it. There you go. Now you're able to change the direction from each side. Sorry, change the length of the extrusion from each side differently, like this. And you can angle just one side, like this. It's really easy. I'm holding the roller in, by the way, and dragging my mouse around. And okay, that's that. There's one more thing you need to know about extruded bus. That's thin feature. If I just enable that, it, as you can see, you just make your part empty inside. So you either put it outside the sketch or inside, and like that. It's really just an option. Really, really helpful, by the way, but it's not really hard to work with. I'm sure you can figure it out. Okay, I'm just gonna have this block over here and make another block to show you other features of that extruded bus, which I mentioned earlier. Okay, I'm going to draw on a sketch. What do I need? A plane. Okay, where do I need a plane? For example, here, front plane. Okay, this menu, just press on the space bar on the keyboard and it pops out anywhere. And it's really helpful. You can see, watch your block, your part from any angle you want. I just need normal too. Okay, I'm going to make another sketch by going to the sketch tab, make a, like a, I'm going to draw a circle like this. Press the escape button to get rid of that symbol. Smart dimension, like for example, that's 7 is good. Now I'm going to extrude this, but this time I'm not going to use the method blind. I'm going to show you the other options. Through all just makes it extruded through all of the part. Like if you had your part till here, that circle would have been extruded up to here. Up to surface, you just need to define a surface. So that circle is extruded till that. Vertex, you need to, it's a little bit more complicated. You need to define a vertex first, then you can choose that and put that as a reference. Offset from a surface, you just need to define the surface over here and type the dimension you want it you want it to be offset from, like this, as you can see. 50 millimeters offset from this plane, that direction. If you want to change the direction, reverse offset like this. Now 50 millimeters from this. Okay. And up to body, you need to have another body just to, like this. Works pretty much the same. Define that and it would be that easy.